Hello everyone, I'm Monica Rana. This is Himachal 365 and you're watching Hillcrest News Channel. Let's start with the headlines. Women Security Traffic Management top on list said a new SP of Hamirpur District. New Shimla SP assumes charge list priorities. MET predicts heavy rain in Himachal Pradesh till August 21. Elderly to get vaccine at home in Himachal Pradesh, government tells High Court. National COVID recovery rate improves to 97.52%, highest since March last year. Transfer of assets of Tibetan schools to NGO opposed in Himachal Pradesh. Protesting HRTC piecemeal workers worried about future. Penalties on illegal mining in Himachal Swan River hiked up to Rs 4 lakh. Nitish Kumar to meet Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday to discuss caste waste census issue. E-registration must for entering Himachal Pradesh. Now news in detail. Women Security Traffic Management top on list said new SP of Hamirpur District. Dr. Akriti Sharma, new superintendent of police, assumed office from yesterday. Describing her priorities as the SP, she said protection of women and traffic management would be her priorities apart from regular policing tasks. She said she wanted to have complete CCTV surveillance of the town as the traffic congestion had become a nuisance and posed threat to pedestrians as well. She stressed the need to impart sex education at home to make child understand the difference in good touch and bad touch. Akriti Sharma said she would work for the welfare of society not only as a police officer but also use her capacity as a qualified doctor if required. New Shimla SP assumed charge list priorities. New methodology would be introduced for crime prevention in the district, said SP Shimla Monica Puttenguru, who took charge yesterday. It is my first day as SP Shimla and I would observe and analyze the crime trend and make strategy accordingly, she said. The fight against drugs would continue. Besides financial investigation in NDPS Act, linkages of backward and forward context would be done. The focus areas would be crime against women, drug trafficking and reducing the number of accidents. Shimla is a famous tourist destination and tourists are welcome, but they are advised to follow COVID norms. MET predicts heavy rain in Himachal till August 21. The weather remained dry in Himachal in the past 48 hours due to subdued monsoons, but the local MET office issued a yellow warning of thunderstorms, lightning and heavy rain at isolated places in middle and lower hills of the state from August 19 to 21. The MET office also predicted thunderstorms and rain in lower and mid hills from August 19 to 24 and rain and snow at isolated places at higher hills from August 20 onwards. Elderly to get vaccine at home in Himachal Pradesh, government tells High Court. Appropriate action would be taken forward to ensure that the medical staff would go to the place of the aged person and administer the vaccination to them throughout the state. This was stated by the counsel for the state before the High Court while hearing a public interest litigation and other petition highlighting inadequate facilities and infrastructure in the state to deal with the corona pandemic. During the course of hearing, it was brought to the notice of the court that certain aged persons are unable to move out of their residence in order to avail the vaccination benefit. National COVID recovery rate improves to 97.52%, highest since March last year. India added 36,401 new COVID infections, taking the total tally of cases to 3,23,22,258. While the death toll has climbed to 4,33,049 with 530 more fatalities, according to the Union Health Ministry data updated on Thursday. The national recovery rate has improved to 97.52%, the highest since March last year, according to the data. The minister said that active cases are declined to 3,64,129, the lowest in 149 days, and comprised 1.13% of the total infection, the lowest since March last year. Transfer of assets of Tibetan schools to NGO opposed in Himachal Pradesh. The parents of students of Central School of Tibetans Chota Shimla are up in arms against the decision of the Union government to hand over property worth crores of rupees belonging to the Central Tibetan Schools Administration CTSA to a Tibetan NGO in violation of Section 118 of the HP Tenancy and Land Reforms Act. Parents along with social workers have decided to file a public interest litigation PIL against the government decision to hand over the property of 45 Tibetan schools to the Sambhuta Tibetan School Society STSS in violation of laws. They argue that a large number of non-Tibetans were also studying in these schools and 12 of 14 schools under the CTSC had been handed over to the Tibetan NGO while the CST at Shimla and Dalhousie would be handed over within a month. Protesting HRTC piecemeal workers worried about future. Around 1,000 piecemeal workers of Himachal Road Transport Corporation HRTC who have gone on tool-down strike across the state are worried about their future. Khem Chand, president of the piecemeal employee union, said, "Most of us have spent 8 to 10 years with the HRTC in the hope that we would be made contractual workers after 5 to 6 years and eventually regularized. As per policy, piecemeal workers were taken on contract till 2017. After 2017, the HRTC management has not taken anyone on contract. As piecemeal workers, we are paid only when we work and our salary doesn't go beyond Rs. 5,000 or Rs. 6,000 per month. Besides, there are no facilities for us. We have given 8 to 10 years to the HRTC in the hope of contractual job. Where will we go now?" he asked. Penalties on illegal mining in Himachal Swan River hiked up to Rs. 4 lakh. Illegal mining in the Swan River and its tributaries in Una district will now invite a penalty of up to Rs. 4 lakh. Earlier, the maximum penalty imposed on vehicles used for illegal mining was Rs. 50,000. District Magistrate Una Raghav Sharma, in an order issued, has increased the penalty on vehicles, equipment or excavators involved in illegal mining at river beds to a maximum of Rs. 4 lakh. The order issued stated that the penalty for vehicles and equipment with a showroom value of over Rs. 25 lakh and less than 5 years old would be Rs. 4 lakh. For equipment between 5 and 10 years old, the penalty would be Rs. 3 lakh and for that over 10 years old, the fine would be Rs. 2 lakh. Nitish Kumar to meet Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday to discuss caste waste census issue. Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar on Wednesday said that he will meet Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday, that is on August 23, to discuss the issue of conducting a caste waste census. Nitish Kumar's party Janata Dal is an ally of the Bharatiya Janata Party in Bihar and is in favor of caste waste census. On Monday, during an interaction with media persons, Nitish Kumar said that he had been advocating the need for caste waste census across the country for a long time. It was done separately between 2011 to 2013. But the report did not come out. We wanted to be with the census at least once to have a clear picture as it will help in planning the policy making for the weaker section, the Chief Minister said. E-registration must for entering Himachal Pradesh. In view of the surge in COVID cases, the Himachal Pradesh government on Wednesday decided to monitor all interstate movements into the state through registration on the e-COVID software. So this is all for this time. Stay connected and keep watching Hillcrest News Channel. Thank you.